If you ever wanted to create such a layout, but not only to get this layout, but also make it dynamic, which is connected to CMS, and you can see that if I click load more, it loads more item and everything layout perfectly. So if you ever wanted to create such a layout, stick around, this tutorial is exactly for you. And you won't believe how simple it is to create. So let's jump to the editor and see how to achieve this layout. All right, so this is the working example that I've already created, but we will rebuild it from scratch from top. So I'm creating a new section. And the first thing that I want to do, I want to create, to put everything inside a single stack element or container, choose whatever you like. So the first thing that I need to do is to add a title. So I'm focusing, let's change it to this gray. I'm focusing on a layout that is dynamic, which means connected to CMS and you can update it outside the website. So for this example, I have a database called video tags, video tutorials tag. This is part of the I'm redesigning my own website. So you can see there is tons of tags here. So I want to connect the repeater to that database and display all the tags, and this layout is working very great because it's very short value. Okay, so it can wrap really nice. So let's change the title just for this example, learn by topic, and let's make it much smaller. Something like this, it will be aligned to the center. All right, so this is our title, but first I will need to add some padding to my section. So let's do 100 pixels and convert it to percentage maybe. Yeah, so this will be aligned to the middle and stick to the top. Right now it's 90%, it doesn't mean anything. Later we will fix everything with the repeater and the CDA. So the second thing that I need is a repeater. So let's add a repeater. Okay, it's coming huge. So let's take a single item and make it much smaller. And actually I don't need three items. I need only one just to get started. Now each item should contain a button. Potentially this button can lead to a dynamic page. So let's create this button. I'll go to buttons because I need to style buttons. So let's drag it right here. Maybe I can even drag it directly inside my repeater item. But first I like to change the title to be topic label. And then I'll drag it back again. So each new item that I'll create it will be with this label. Now I don't really need the height. I will get the height from the layout. So let's add 16 pixels padding and it's automatically connected everything to be the same value. Now I'll disconnect it and change this one, the left and right, to be 24 pixels. So now I'll get a beautiful button. The text should be changed based on my own design system, which will be Lato Black. Oh no. Text. It will be Lato Bold. Let's change its color to this color that is connected to my theme. The background will be this gray. I will add some corners, 12 pixels, something like this. And I want to create a hover effect. So let's change the hover. Instead of white, it will be darker gray. The text will be orange. And I want to have a border which will be also orange. But first I want to show you something. Let's change the setting of each repeater item to be same as the height of the content, which is the row should be 1FR. And just let's make it a bit transparent. So later we'll fix it. But I want to show you what's happened when I added a border only on the hover. So let's change it to be orange. So if you look closely, so when I'm hovering, you can see that the button actually getting higher, okay? Because on the hover state, I have border. In the default state, I don't have a border. So to avoid this layout change, I'll go to the regular state and add a border. But here I will change it to be transparent. And so it does have a border, but you don't see it. So now when I'm hovering the button, the button stay at the same height. All right, so this was a quick tip. And now we need to change the width of each repeater items to be as max as the button width. Okay, so first of all, let's change the width of single item to be 100%. Now it's too big. Okay, and we need to change the item width to be max content, but you can see that it's disabled right here. So I don't need to scale the scale proportion, but I do need to change the settings of the repeater. By the way, it should be cards. I need to change it not to have set items per row. I don't want it, okay? So now if I'll select the item, you can see that I can now change the width. So I need to change it to be max content. So the reason that this button is getting this size is because it has 24 pixels padding from left and right. Okay, for example, if I'll select the button and remove this padding, so now it's reached to the edge of the value, the label. So 24 pixels. All right, but you can see that we see some background color. It came from the item background. So let's remove it. It will be transparent. And I'm making sure that I don't have minimum height for the item itself. So let's remove it to be FR. So now it's exactly the same height as the button. And also you can see that I have minimum width of 50 pixels. Usually I will get rid of it. But here it can be useful because sometimes I have label that is very short. So I want to have some minimum width. Maybe when I bind it to data, you can see it. So the last thing that I need is the load more button. So let's just copy it from here. Maybe change its design a little bit. So it's too small. So let's match it to our single button. So it will be 16 pixels and then 24 from left and 24 from right. And I need to change the height because now it's fixed height. I need to set it to be auto. And let's change the title to be 13 pixels, something like this. And you can see that its width is it's fixed. I can change it by dragging like this. So now what do we need to do? We need to stack everything together so they will respect each other. So I'm selecting the label, the title, the repeater, and the CTA, the button, and stack them together. Now I can set a width to the stack itself to be 50% of the of its own parent, which is this section, and I can align everything to the center by click align items like this. The title, it should be 100% or max content. I always preferred 100%. Usually, yeah. So the gaps between the element, and I can set them all together. Here, let's make it 32 pixels, something like this. All right. I think the proportion is not right, but you know, it's not that important. All right. So we have everything we need. Now what we need to do is to connect these repeater items to the database. So let's connect it to, I already have the video tutorials tags dataset, which is connected to the database. And you can see it's immediately populating data from the database, 12 items. This is the default, so let's keep it that way. And maybe I want to add sort of title A to Z. All right, so now let's connect the button label to display the title of the topic. So you can see that everything is A to Z. So A first, B second. And we want to click load more to load more items. So again, I'm binding to data set, and the click action is the load more. So let's publish it to see the live results. So you will see that it's not quite the same layout, but if I click load more, it loads more item. And now is the trick. So I played around with it, and when I inspect the repeater layout, I notice that this is flex. So it's flex. Basically, I can select each item. So you can see this is the item selector, that if I'm hovering it, it's selecting all the items. And if I'll set it to each item to be flex grow, I'll set it to 1, I'm getting this layout. Okay, so let's see what's happening if I click load more. You can see that the layout is automatically matching each item width to see if to fit as much as it as possible at the same row. And if I'll change the width, you can see that everything is rearranged perfectly. This is the power of Flexbox and Flexbox Grow. So how can we implement same design in our to our repeater? So we will use custom CSS to do it, but there is a small trick. So I found that for some reason I cannot add, I mean I can, but it's not working. I cannot add a custom CSS class to the repeater itself. So the trick is to give it to its own parent. So I'll select this stack and give it a meaningful class name. So I'll call it top learn by topics rep, it's shortcut of repeater wrapper. Okay, this is just an example of a name. And then I'll click to open the CSS file, okay, which is, if it will be closed, it will open this file, okay? And imagine that this entire code block is empty. So here I'll add the class name. It should start with the dot. The class name, but I need to select the repeater item. So if I'll select the repeater, you can see that I have class name for the repeater and I have for the repeater item. So I'll refer to the repeater and then to the repeater item. I don't have to use the repeater because I can refer like this, but I think it's good practice, so you know that it's related. And that now I'll try to do flex grow equals to 1. So again, the stack parent has the custom CSS class and it refer to this item. Okay. So now let's publish it to see if it's working. So it's working, as you can see. And if I click load more, everything is rearranged perfectly. I want to show you here we have 5 items. So at the beginning, it started with 4 items. But because I click load more and the second one is smaller and it fit into this width, so it has 5 and everything working amazingly. And the beautiful thing is that it's actually connected to a repeater, which is dynamic. So you can really use it in creative way to display very unique layout in your website, and it's super, super, super responsive. So you can see that it's fit itself very, very nicely. All right, so that's it. And until next time, keep building amazing websites on Wix Studio.